got rabbit ears.
So this is my second week here out in the States. We just finished up the CSW World Conference with Sensei Erik Paulson here. It was amazing. We had a lot of great people, Higa Machado, Greg Nelson, Rick Young, Nikolai,
Tim Tackett,
Ben Jones. It was just an epic 4 days. I come in as a white belt. I was really happy to be a white belt, and I was just wanting to learn and just really happy with that mentality. And then after that day, Coach handed me this, and now I really have to get my act together and stay on top of my game because people start to headhunt you. But I wanted to ask Sensei Erik here what the significance is, what it takes to go from white to blue, and then from blue then on out, what we should be thinking about. So,
well, the white to blue is very important because it's your basics. It's the mastery of all the basics. It's all your exercises. You learn how to tie your belt, you learn how to roll, you learn how to move, you learn how to shrimp, you learn how to bridge, you learn how to sprawl, you learn sit-outs. You're learning the basics, five of five positions, which is crossbody, close guard, mount, back control, face up, face down, and then kneeling. They're starting on their knees or you're fighting in turtle, and you're either on top or on the bottom, or you start on your knees also. So those are the address positions. They say jiu-jitsu should fit in the palm of your hands, and that's what the blue belt is about, is getting to the point where you're comfortable with the positions, the transitions, the escapes, and the attacks. Those are the four things. Positioning, transitions, defense, escapes, and then your attacks. Now when we take the gi off, we address more than anything is more wrestling and more attacking. But with the gi, we work a lot of the defense, the positions, the control, the balance, the base, and then you start to learn your basic attacks that you have to know. Your triangle, your armbar, your choke, your umaplata, the back choke, the short choke, the big monk de leon, the single naked stringer, the front guillotine, maybe the front gravit or the face lock. A lot of the things that we address are what you're going to be using the rest of your career in jiu-jitsu. So the white to blue is very important, and you can only just get better every day. So it's like suddenly you get a blue belt, you don't go, oh my God, I need to know this. No, the fact is that you've been training for at least a year to 2 years for your blue belt. You're on the mat rolling regularly. You're doing okay. You have a lot to figure out, but that's what the blue belt is. It's not in the old days when I trained in the garage with the Gracies, the blue belt was a black belt. I remember peeking in there and looking in there as a white belt going, man, oh my gosh, it's all blue belts in there. And I remember the first time I saw a guy with a purple belt, I was like, oh, what the heck? What's that color? I can't, what's that? Oh my God, it's a purple belt. What does that mean? And then the purple belt, because there weren't very many purple belts, and they were all blue belts, and most of them obviously were Brazilian. You see a purple belt, and they were farther than the blue belt because of the fact that they had more of a game, more time on the mat, basically. And it was about, so on the average, white to blue is about anywhere from 1 to 2, some people are 3 years. And then purple belt, about 4 to 6 years, something like that. And then the more time you put in, I mean, some guys get better faster, and how many days a week you're training, how serious you are about training, how many times a week you're training, do you compete, do you drill, what else do you do besides this that will assist this, will assist jiu-jitsu to get you better at jiu-jitsu. Most people will say only jiu-jitsu will get you better at jiu-jitsu, but swimming, I mean, look at some exercise, swimming, running, judo, obviously, wrestling, and then just rolling and rolling and rolling and getting used to wearing a gi. I mean, it takes about a month to get comfortable having a gi on regularly, but once you do, then you can take advantage of it and you go, hey, wait a second, this is like wrestling, but it's cheating because I get to grab the clothes. And so now your controls are there, your grips are different, and then more than anything, when you don't, if you're rolling with a gi and you're feeling comfortable for it, pretend you don't have it on. Just roll like you're not wearing one. And then later on, you work about how to strip the grip, and then you work all the different chokes. But more than anything, the blue belt is positioning, your positioning, your controlling, your transitions, and then your defense. And then you're gonna start to learn attacks. You don't need that many attacks, just gotta learn the basics so you can identify what you're up against.